Today on The Source, training for Lou. Players, coaches and fans alike remember a lost icon. Plus an early insight into our trip to Greater Western Sydney. Flowers lay at the foot of the Lou Richards statue this morning, a day after the tragic passing of the man it represents. Lou Richards was 94 at the time of his death, and today Collingwood supporters flocked to the Holden Centre to pay tributes to the great Louis the Lib.
I just loved the way he was. He was loud, he was honest, he was truthful, and he was just proud Collingwood, and I'm just happy to be here with him paying my tribute. So,
thought he was a superstar, legend of the club, funny bloke. I actually put stuff on his statue over there, a beanie and a scarf, which I thought was quite appropriate.
I think he means a lot. Yeah, well, I think the AFL should have made him a legend because he's done so much for football, not just playing, everything. And I can't see how they can say that he doesn't fit the criteria.
Collingwood's current players trained in the shadows of the great Lou Richards today. When they stepped onto Olympic Park Oval, his 1953 Premiership Cup was there to greet them. Coach Nathan Buckley later reflected on his memories of Richards and was under no illusions of Lou's lasting legacy.
No, well, Lou's, he was ever present. One of the things he was able to achieve is surpass or overshadow his career as a player. Well, he had 250 games, Premiership captain, through the 40s and 50s, and but sort of everyone forgot about that. And by the time that he got in front of a camera and did what he did as a media personality, he became, everyone's Lou Richards, not just Collingwood's. So to be able to break the mould and not be despised as a Collingwood person in the wider footy public was a fair effort, and he did it just with charm, charisma, always up for a laugh, didn't take himself too seriously or others. I think there's probably something in that.
Attention turned to on-field action and early preparations for a clash against Greater Western Sydney on Saturday. Adam Traore today only trained lightly, and Buckley admitted he isn't 100% fit. But the coach expects his star midfielder to make the trip to Sydney.
He'd be in some doubt, but we expect him to play. Yeah. This is as I've been pilloried for. We did have a brace of games that were pretty tightly. Not a lot of rest in between. So. You get to the other side of that, and we were planning to take the early stage of this week just to settle, reset, make sure that we monitor the group, and then make the right decisions coming out of that. And we will, we'll have 22 of the fittest, hungriest Collingwood footballers that we have going into the game on Saturday.
Traore will have another chance to prove his fitness when the Magpies train again here on Thursday morning. Meanwhile, tributes for the great Lou Richards will be communicated within the coming days. That's all for a Tuesday edition of The Source. Go Pies.